हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग. यू आर वेलकम इन द लेक्चर नंबर 14. दैट इज लास्ट लेक्चर ऑफ ए चैप्टर ऑफ आयोनिक इक्विलिब्रियम. इन द लास्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन कॉमन आयन इफेक्ट फॉलोड बाय वन न्यूमेरिकल एग्जाम्पल फ्रॉम क्वेश्चन नंबर 3. एंड दैट problem is problem number 10 from the question number 3. In this lecture also we are continuing with the numerical examples. Now the problem number 6, numerical example number 6 from question number 3. This is acetic acid is 5% ionized in its decimolar solution. They have given the acetic acid solution. That is 5% ionized in its decimolar solution. Calculate the dissociation constant of acid. While solving any problem, as usual, on the right hand side, write given data of the problem. In the given data, they have given a solution of acid. Solution of acid is given, that is acetic acid, and that acetic acid is 5% ionized, means percent alpha is given as 5%. Percent alpha is 5. Ionized in its decimolar solution. Concentration of the solution is given, concentration C. Decimolar means it is 0.1. See, you must know these facts. Decamolar will be equal to 10 molar. Then just molar. Molar means 1 molar. Then decimolar. Decimolar means 0.1 molar. Like this. So concentration of acetic acid is 0.1 molar. Percent alpha they have given 5%. And they have asked to calculate dissociation constant of acid. So here K is dissociation constant. For acid it is A. Ka we have to calculate. Dissociation constant of acid is nothing but Ka equal to question mark, that we have to calculate. So that is the given data of the problem. Now solution. While solving this problem, we have to follow certain steps. First of all, percent alpha is given. And we have to calculate Ka. That is the Ostwald dilution law, mathematical law. And according to Ostwald dilution law, Ka is equal to alpha square C divided by 1 minus alpha is there, but there that alpha is negligible as compared with 1. So simply it is K is equal to alpha square C. See, in some of the books it is given like this also, K is equal to alpha square C upon 1 minus alpha, but this alpha is very much less as compared with 1 for weak acid. Therefore, 1 minus alpha is equal to 1. And we can write Ka is equal to alpha square into C. So this equation we are not using directly. We are using this equation Ka is equal to alpha square C according to Ostwald dilution law. But here you must keep in mind that this alpha is not a percent alpha. This alpha is not percent alpha. It is the degree of dissociation. Degree. It is a fraction of total moles which have undergone dissociation. Fraction of total moles which have undergone dissociation is known as degree of dissociation alpha. It is not percent alpha. They have given percent alpha. So percent alpha will be equal to alpha into 100. We have to use alpha only. That alpha will be equal to percent alpha divided by 100. Now percent alpha is given as 5%. 5 upon 100. Therefore alpha will be equal to 0.05. This is a fraction of total moles of an electrolyte which have undergone dissociation. The fraction of total moles of an electrolyte which have undergone dissociation is the degree of dissociation alpha. And this type of alpha we have to use in order to calculate Ka, dissociation constant of acid. Now it is very simple. The calculations are now very simple. Just we have to substitute for alpha and we have to substitute for C. We know alpha 0.05. We know C concentration 0.1 decimolar. Decimolar means 0.1. So substituting the values in this equation of Ostwald dilution law, we can calculate dissociation constant of acid as K is equal to alpha square C. Alpha square 0.05 square into C, that is 0.1. Simplify this. For simplification, we can write it like this. This is 5 into 10 raised to minus 2 square. This will be 5 into 10 raised to minus 2 because 2 decimals on left side. This will be multiplied by 10 raised to minus 1. Now solving this, Ka 5 square is 25. 10 raised to minus 2 square, 10 raised to minus 4 into 10 raised to minus 1. So Ka will be equal to 25 into 10 raised to minus 5. One decimal is given always. It is written in this format, no matter, 2.5. So I have taken one decimal on left side. This will become now 10 raised to minus 4. So 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 4 is the dissociation constant of this weak acid, acetic acid. You got it? While solving any problem, we have to follow these steps. First of all, write the given data. First step, write given data of the problem. Then solution, required equation, and the data for required equation is to be produced. This is how the problem is solved. See it once again. Acetic acid, which is weak acid, this is 5% ionized in decimolar solution. Calculate the dissociation constant. Since it is weak acid, percent alpha is given as 5%. Percent alpha is 5. Decimolar means concentration of solution is 0.1. Since we know deca means 10, molar means 1, deci means 0.1. Calculate the dissociation constant of acid Ka. Solution. According to Ostwald dilution law, Ka will be equal to alpha square C divided by 1 minus alpha is there, but that alpha is very small as compared with 1. Therefore, denominator is neglected. Simply, Ka is equal to alpha square C, but this alpha is not percent alpha. They have given percent alpha. That percent alpha should be converted to alpha. Alpha is equal to percent alpha upon 100. So alpha will be 0.05. This is substituted here. Concentration is 0.1. Substituting and solving this, we will get the value of dissociation constant of acetic acid as 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 4. This is the problem number 6 from question number 3 from your textbook given at the end of chapter. Given at the end of chapter. Now let us see the next problem, that is problem number 9 from your book. Now see, प्रॉब्लम नंबर 9 फ्रॉम योर बुक, पीएच ऑफ वीक मोनोबेसिक एसिड, दिस इज ऑल्सो एसिड एंड द पीएच ऑफ एसिड इज गिवन एज 3.2. कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ दैट एसिड सोल्यूशन इज 0.02 मोलर. कैलकुलेट द डिसोसिएशन कॉन्सेंट ऑफ एसिड. सो अगेन राइट द गिवन डाटा ऑफ ए प्रॉब्लम. गिवन डाटा ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम, दे हैव गिवन वीक एसिड हैविंग ए पीएच 3.2, कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑफ द सोल्यूशन 0.02 मोलर मीन्स मोल पर डेसीमीटर क्यूब. कैलकुलेट द डिसोसिएशन कॉन्सेंट ऑफ एसिड के ए. नाउ सी द स्टेप्स. सोल्यूशन व्हाइल सॉल्विंग दिस प्रॉब्लम, सी द स्टेप्स. पीएच इज गिवन, फ्रॉम पीएच वी कैन कैलकुलेट एच प्लस आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. देन फ्रॉम दैट एच प्लस आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन वी कैन कैलकुलेट अल्फा, डिग्री ऑफ डिसोसिएशन. एंड फ्रॉम डिग्री ऑफ डिसोसिएशन इन द थर्ड स्टेप वी कैन कैलकुलेट डिसोसिएशन कॉन्स्टेंट. सी फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट एच प्लस आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. सेकेंडली दिस इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप, कैलकुलेट एच प्लस आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. देन कैलकुलेट अल्फा फ्रॉम एच प्लस आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. एंड थर्ड स्टेप कैलकुलेट के ए, डिसोसिएशन कॉन्स्टेंट ऑफ एसिड. सो लेट अस सी हाउ टू कैलकुलेट इट वन बाय वन. फर्स्ट कैलकुलेशन, कैलकुलेशन ऑफ एच प्लस आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. सिंस वी नो पीएच इज इक्वल टू माइनस लॉग टू द बेस 10 ऑफ एच प्लस आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, हाइड्रोजन आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, यू कैन राइट इट एज हाइड्रोनियम आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन ऑल्सो, एच थ्री ओ प्लस, बिकॉज एच प्लस ओ एच माइनस एंड एच थ्री ओ प्लस आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन आर सेम. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ एच प्लस इवन यू कैन राइट एच थ्री ओ प्लस ऑल्सो, दैट इज वन एंड सेम, नो मैटर इन द कैलकुलेशन. पीएच इज इक्वल टू माइनस लॉग ऑफ एच प्लस आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. पीएच इज गिवन एंड वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट एच प्लस. सी हाउ टू सॉल्व दिस. टेक निगेटिव साइन ऑन लेफ्ट साइड. सो व्हाट इट बिकम, लॉग टू द बेस 10 ऑफ एच प्लस आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन इज इक्वल टू माइनस पीएच. निगेटिव साइन आई हैव टेकन ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड. दिस लॉग वी हैव टू कैंसल. सो दिस विल बी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय एंटी लॉग, बिकॉज एंटी लॉग एंड लॉग आर अपोजिट प्रोसेसेस ऑफ इच अदर. दिस साइड मस्ट बी मल्टीप्लाइड बाय एंटी लॉग. देयरफॉर ऑन राइट साइड ऑल्सो एंटी लॉग विल बी टेकन. ऑन लेफ्ट साइड एंटी लॉग इंटू लॉग टू द बेस 10 ऑफ एच प्लस आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन विल बी इक्वल टू एंटी लॉग ऑफ माइनस पी एच. एंटी लॉग लॉग कैंसल्ड. देयरफॉर एच प्लस आयन कॉन्सेंट्रेशन will be equal to anti log of minus pH. Now substituting value, H plus ion concentration is equal to anti log of minus pH. pH is given as 3.2. This we have to solve. But to see the anti log of this type of term, it is rather a bit tedious. Be careful while looking for a log of anti-log of minus 3.2. Anti-log starts with which term? 0.00 and ends with 0.99. This is minus, means less than 0. So we cannot see the anti-log of this term. This should be modified. So how to modify? Here mantissa is negative because this negative sign is common. So mantissa is negative. Add plus 1 to this mantissa, therefore minus 1 to the characteristic. In the yesterday's problem, last lecture problem, problem number 10, what we have done? That opposite process here we have to do. There what we have done? Characteristic minus, there we have added plus, and in the mantissa we have added minus 1. But here what we are doing? Opposite way. Mantissa is negative, so add plus 1 in the mantissa. Characteristic is negative, add that minus 1 in the characteristic. So minus 1 and plus 1, opposite pattern here. To see the antilog, H plus ion concentration will be equal to antilog of minus 3, minus 1, plus 1, and this is minus 0.2. See, minus 1 plus 1 cancelled. What is the remaining term? Minus 3.2, one and same. Why I have done like this? Because we can see the antilog of only positive term and this is negative. So I have added plus 1 to that negative and that plus 1 is subtracted from the characteristic, no matter. Therefore, H plus ion concentration will be equal to antilog of minus 3 minus 1 means bar 4 point plus 1 minus 2. This will be 0.8. This is plus 0.8 now. Plus 1 is greater than 0.2. Therefore, answer is plus 0.8. Mantissa is plus 0.8. Now we can easily see the antilog. Antilog of 0.8 H plus ion concentration will be equal to antilog of 8.8, that is equal to, you also have a book with you. The antilog of that term is nothing but 6310. We'll see it once again. 6310. 6310. Antilog of 0.8. Bar 4 considered as 0. So this will become 10 raised to minus 4. 0. I have considered 0. Therefore 0 plus 1 means 1. 6.310 into 10 raised to minus 4 mole per decimeter cube is the concentration of hydrogen ion. This is one part of the problem. We have calculated here hydrogen ion concentration. This is important now. Here, this calculation is important to calculate the hydrogen ion concentration. Why to do minus 1 plus 1? How to simplify it? That is important part. So this is the calculation of hydrogen ion concentration. Now second calculation, alpha. Alpha for weak acid is H plus ion concentration upon total concentration. We know this H plus ion concentration. And total concentration is 0.02. So alpha will be equal to H plus ion concentration 6.310 into 10 raised to minus 4 divided by concentration. They have given 0.02. Simplify this. Simplifying this, if we make this 2, this will be 31. So alpha will be equal to 631 divided by 2 into 10 raised to minus 4. 631 divided by 2. Now very simple calculation. Alpha is equal to 315.5. This will be 315.5 into 10 raised to minus 4. Or it is written as alpha is equal to 3.15.5 into 10 raised to minus 2. This will be alpha. You got it? How I have simplified here? 0.02 I have taken 2 decimal to the right side. So this also taken 2 decimal to the right side. 631. 631 divided by 2. That will be 315.5 into 10 raised to minus 4. But as our regular format, just one decimal given here, two decimal taken on left side. So this will become now 10 raised to minus 2. This is the alpha. And from alpha, we have to calculate final answer Ka, dissociation constant, and that is by the regular steps. So which are the regular steps now to calculate dissociation constant from alpha? What is that equation? Ka is equal to alpha square C. Now you know the alpha. So third calculation, Ka is equal to alpha square multiplied by C. Alpha square, that alpha we know, 3.1555 into 10 raised to minus 2 square into concentration is 0.02. Now very simple, 10 raised to minus 2 becomes 10 raised to minus 4, this is 0.02, and the square of this one, you know how to make a square. You can do it either using log table or can perform the direct calculation, so that finally you will come to the final answer, and that final answer will be 1.9845. This will be 1.9845 into 10 raised to minus 5. This is the final answer what we are getting. How to solve this? Make a square of this term. Square of 10 raised to minus 2 is 10 raised to minus 4. And this is 2 into 10 raised to minus 2. Or I am writing one more step here. 3.155 square. 10 raised to 2 square is 10 raised to minus 4. Then this is 2 into 10 raised to minus 2. So what it become? 3.155 square into 2 into 10 raised to minus 6. And if you solve this, you must get this answer. That is the dissociation constant of acid. 1.9845, maybe almost equal to 1.99, approximately 1.99 into 10 raised to minus 5. That is the dissociation constant of weak monobasic acid having pH 3.2. So if you are given the pH, calculate first, in the first step, H plus ion concentration. Then calculate degree of dissociation. And finally calculate the dissociation constant. Now let us see one more problem from question number 4. At the end of book, in question number 4, they have given problem number 9. Let us see that one more problem. Now see, this is pH of water, pH of rain water collected in certain region of Maharashtra is 5.1. Calculate the hydrogen ion concentration of rain water and its percentage dissociation. Again given data, in the given data they have given pH is equal to 5.1. Then they have asked to calculate hydrogen ion concentration. So H plus ion concentration is equal to question mark. And then we have to calculate percent alpha. So very simple. Just now we have seen from pH we can calculate H plus ion concentration. One step just now we have seen in the last problem. Problem number 9 of question 3. Now this is the problem number 9 of question number 4. Question number 4, problem number 9. We know how to calculate hydrogen ion concentration. So H plus ion concentration, just now we have studied, will be equal to anti-log of minus pH. So it is H plus ion concentration will be equal to anti-log of minus 5.1. Again, in the similar manner, we cannot see the anti-log of minus 0.1. Minus 0.1, we cannot say anti-log. Therefore, convert it. Simplify it. H plus ion concentration will be equal to anti-log of minus 5, minus 1, plus 1, and minus 0.1. So, this will become H plus ion concentration is equal to anti log of bar 6.9 minus 1 plus 1. If this is cancelled, the remaining term will be minus 5.1. But we cannot see the anti log of minus 5.1 directly. Therefore, I have simplified this term, simplified as bar 6.9. Now we can see the anti log of 0.9. So H plus ion concentration will be equal to anti log of 0.9. With you also, there is the log anti log chart. 0.9 have 7943. 7943. Bar 6. That is 10 raised to minus 6. So what is here? I have considered 0. Means point will be here. 7.943 into 10 raised to minus 6 mole per decimeter cube. Mole per decimeter cube. That is the hydrogen ion concentration. So half part we have completed. Hydrogen ion concentration of rainwater is this one, or approximately 8 into 10 raised to minus 6. 8 into 10 raised to minus 6. That is the hydrogen ion concentration. Now what is second part? Second part we have to calculate percent dissociation. Percent dissociation. We know the degree of dissociation, alpha. Degree of dissociation is defined as a fraction of total moles which have undergone dissociation. Fraction of total moles of an electrolyte which have undergone dissociation is known as degree of dissociation. Means, in 1 liter, suppose if we consider 1 liter solution, calculate the total concentration and the ions dissociated. Theoretically, we have studied while looking for a pH, we have seen that water is very weak electrolyte, very weak electrolyte, and it undergo dissociation very weakly, partially. Concentration of H plus ion is 10 raised to minus 7. Concentration of OH minus ion is also 10 raised to minus 7. In 1 liter, if we take a liter of water, 1 liter of water, we have H plus ion concentration 10 raised to minus 7, OH minus ion concentration also 10 raised to minus 7. So H plus ion concentration divided by total concentration of water. What is the H plus ion concentration in pure water 10 raised to minus 7 moles per liter? This is out of question now. This we don't have to consider in that calculation. What is total concentration of water? H plus ion concentration in pure water will be 10 raised to minus 7 mole per liter, or moles per decimeter cube. Total concentration of water is mass upon molar mass. Mass upon molar mass. So H plus ion concentration we know it is nothing but 10 raised to minus 7 divided by concentration of water, mass upon molar mass. What is the mass we are considering? 1 liter volume, density of water is 1. So mass is also 1000. 1 liter means 1000 centimeter cube, that is 1000 gram, divided by molar mass 18 of water. Now very simple to solve this. Alpha is equal to 10 raised to minus 7 into 18 divided by 1000. So this is 18 into 10 raised to minus 7 into 10 raised to plus 3. At numerator it will be 10 raised to minus 3. So alpha become 18 into 10 raised to minus 10. This is not percent alpha, it is the alpha. And convert this to percent alpha. Percent alpha will be equal to 18 into 10 raised to minus 10 into 100, means 10 raised to 2. Therefore, percent alpha will become equal to 18 into 10 raised to minus 8 plus 2. So, 10 raised to minus 8. Or if it is also written like this in the format 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 7. So, the percent alpha will be 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 7 in this manner. How I have calculated here? This part we know. How to calculate? This part you know. But the calculation of this part is new. And it is based on theory part also. In the theory we have studied, whenever 1 liter of water is taken, just 10 raised to 7 moles of H plus ion are obtained and 10 raised to 7 moles of OH minus ions are obtained. So H plus ion concentration is 10 raised to minus 7 divided by total concentration of water. What is the concentration? Concentration is mass, that is number of moles. Number of moles of water. Mass of water divided by molar mass. Mass of water 1000 gram because density is 1. Divided by molar mass 18 H2O 2 hydrogen 2 plus oxygen 16, therefore 18. You got it? Why we have taken 18 here? Because this is the 18. And divided by this 18, 18 taken at the numerator. Very simple now. Without any log we can perform the calculations. 18 into 10 raised to minus 7. This is 10 raised to 3 at denominator. Minus 3 at the numerator. It becomes 10 raised to minus 10. 18 into 10 raised to minus 10. That is alpha. Degree of dissociation. Convert this to the percent alpha. So multiplied by 100. Means 10 raised to 2. It becomes 18 into 10 raised to minus 8. And as our regular format, we are writing as 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 7. So that is there about the calculation of pH of rainwater. Since given 5.1, we have calculated H plus and we have calculated the percent dissociation. Question number 4, problem number 9. Here we have studied the calculation over here. This part is important. This is new part. This is the important. So with this, we have completed the chapter of ionic equilibrium from all aspects, from all corners. The necessary problems which are given at the end of chapter, those problems also, we have seen the solution here. Now, you can write the assignments already supplied to you. You can write the notes already supplied to you and perform the study as well from this chapter of ionic equilibrium. So with this, we have completed a chapter of ionic equilibrium.